Wow, let's check out this crawler. It looks pretty promising at first glance.
USB charger, Chinese instruction manual, screwdriver, and the battery in the back. It was secure with the screw. This tiny little battery. Look at the size of this. And guess what? The way that they had it put together with this bulging up, it actually does not fit in there. You have to force fit the battery in order to close this battery lid. I can't close it with now. Let's check out this wheel. Oh wow, this sucks. Where are you gonna get find spare parts or spare wheels for this? Well, anyway, let's put it back on. Well, actually, don't be fooled by this friction shocks. Metal body, very thin metal drive shaft, but plastic gear, extremely weak motor. Well, I should say gearing. It's just not even enough power to power the car up a slope. So you'll see some footage later on, and you'll see what I mean.
Yes, that's the sound of the car struggling to run.
Stuck. Wow, seriously? It cannot back up. Wow. Full power. Oh no. Ah, shoot, I get stuck again. No power, I can't get up. Oh. No. And what? Seriously? Alright, I think I have enough of this. Let me find this a stick there. Huh? What? Lock back up. Forget about going up here. Alright. How about this?
Okay, that's it. Let's check out the diff, or if there's one. Well, as you can see, there's no diff in there, it's just a direct drive, and the gear is plastic as well. I can't believe I spent $90 on this piece of junk. Absolutely stay away from this car. Just forget about this. Well, I got about 9 minutes of runtime.